you grow up kind of neglecting to realize that you have all four limbs and you have all your senses and you have all your motor skills, and to instantly have that change is just, it's devastating.
When I was diagnosed with muscular dystrophy, I knew that I had to stay active, but I didn't think I'd ever be able to compete again.
It feels awesome to finally get in my own chair.
That's awesome. Can't wait.
It's the same as using a rental car all the time and then getting fit for your own Formula One race cars.
And I had a lot of great mentors and friends that were also kind of telling me the same thing and comparing me to, you know, Job in the Bible. And continuing through the adaptive sports, it's just made me feel a lot more normal again.
The Military Adaptive Sports Program, or MASP as we call it, is really a creative program that allows military members who are recovering from injury or illness to engage in all kinds of activities.
MASP is the Military Adaptive Sports Program, and if a civilian asked me what that was, I would definitely say it's part of recovery.
The Military Adaptive Sports Program, I can probably sum it up in one word, and that's empowering.
This is our time. This is our year. All we got to do is stick to it and do what we need to do. All right? Hey, hey, hey! 1, 2, 3!
Hey, let's get that chill out!
MASP is the opportunity for military guys who are wounded, ill, or injured to get a chance to get out and compete in an adaptive sport. Sometimes it's not just the basketball or the volleyball or the swimming, but there's things like archery and game sports such as hunting, and it allows us to get out and become competitive again, and it gives us to get back to some of the natural things that we were used to doing before.
There are many benefits to the MASP program. One is certainly that it helps speed up the recovery process, but two, it connects us with people so that we engage with people who are going through the same type of physical or emotional trauma that we've been through. It also encourages us to move on in our lives.
It's pretty cool.
MASP is the Military Adaptive Sports Programs, where they adapt sports to people with disabilities. For example, we'll do wheelchair basketball, which is a lot more brutal than regular basketball.
MASP is the Military Adaptive Sports Program, and for me, you know, ever since I got out of the hospital, it's been something that has encouraged me, motivated me, kept me going, and shown me all along the way that even though I have these injuries and I can't compete in an able body field, I'm still able to compete at a high level in adaptive sports.
If you could send your wounded warrior to one of these adaptive sports camps to help aid their recovery, you take years off of their recovery. You take years off of their absence from the workforce. You avoid divorce, domestic violence, substance abuse. You avoid those things simply by introducing a wounded warrior to adaptive sports in their recovery. And you add elements that money can't buy, like quality of life.
MASP absolutely changes lives. It not only for the recovering warrior, but for their family. That's very important as well. We have programs where families can participate, but when an adult who's recovering from some injury or illness, you know, believes that they can be successful. That just kind of permeates throughout the family. Instead of sitting at home, you know, kind of feeling sorry for yourself, if you can show your kids, hey, I can get back up and I can go on and do things, it's very important, I think, for the entire family to be able to see that.
Back in 2010 to 2011, I volunteered to go downrange with the Army Corps of Engineers. So I was actually an Air Force guy in an Army uniform, going out to different project sites all around Baghdad.
I was injured 2009 in Iraq. Actually, it happened 4 years ago, and today is actually the day that they took my leg away, so I really don't want to talk about it.
April 11th, 2012, we were flying cleanup for a mission that was going on in southern Morocco. We were part of the administrative movement on the backside, and we had just dropped off a second load of Marines.
I went through officer candidate school in Newport, Rhode Island, and then went through the rest of my training pipeline. And right before I was supposed to go to my amphibious assault ship, I fell on a submarine.
I am a combat controller in the Air Force. I was riding along with a Special Forces team in the Army. I was in the back of a up-armored vehicle, and our vehicle rolled over an IED, and I sustained extreme injuries to both of my lower extremities.
I was following three Afghanistan National Army personnel, and I was right behind them, and all of a sudden I crossed the canal, and then I realized that I was in the air and there was dust everywhere, and I couldn't really hear very well, and then I landed face down in a ditch.
And they set up, after we went through for us on the way back, first out of four vehicles got hit by a conventional IED. The third vehicle, which I was in, got hit by an explosively formed penetrating IED.
IED!
So it was a copper plate that forms a fragment from the explosiveness and punches through the armor. So it traveled through our vehicle about 2 feet in front of my forehead, dislodged all the displays and lights, and blew out a lot of the upholstery. Knocked me unconscious, I have some compression fractures in my thoracic spine, and a traumatic brain injury from the blast.
The aircraft impacted nose first, almost straight down, from about 65 feet, about a 3 second ride. And remember two things. One, that I was upset that I was gonna die in Morocco, of all the places I've been, all the things I've seen. And then the realization that my legs were getting ripped off.
So I got hauled into medical, and we found that I had a lot of muscle damage. And the medical facilities were wonderful. They tested me right away for a type of muscular dystrophy, and it turned out that I had it.
I sustained injuries to both of my legs below the knees. I had multiple fractures in the end state after 26 surgeries of limb salvage procedure, as both of my ankles are completely fused in place, so my feet will never be able to move again.
And so when I woke up after surgery, they to realize and feel the head of the bed, and there was no toes there and there was no ankle there, it really hit home. And then I uncovered my leg and I realized that it was in bandage and it was gone. I was confused and I was dazed, and then I was realizing that my wife was back home and she was pregnant, and the first thing that started rushing through my head is, I'm supposed to be a dad, I'm supposed to be a dad, I'm supposed to be a dad. And I was screaming it and crying at the same time, holding my father's hand, and he said, you still will be, you still will be. And that, I think that stuck with me through this the most, is that I'm still a dad, and I have to live up to that.
Laying in the hospital bed and going on the medevacs to Germany and then down to Brooke Army Medical Center, I would have never thought in my wildest dreams I'd be in the Warrior Games alone and then becoming an ultimate champion. It kind of boggles my mind.
Everybody has to look at each other. If you see a guy struggling and he hasn't come by you, you got to back it off just a little bit.
just very lightly until they come past, and then you'll get the feel for everybody around you.
I was always interested in cycling, and I'd done it a lot before, and it's a medium impact sport, which also helped my illness out a lot.
I chose basketball quite naturally because it was my favorite sport growing up as a kid. I did it every single day of my life, so quite naturally I gravitated towards basketball. In the process of going to basketball camps, I started to learn to pick up other sports such as sit volleyball, which I became very comfortable with because of the competitive nature of the sport.
I enjoy being athletic. I enjoy being on a track. It lightens up my life when I get to do the things that I've always wanted to do. And to train at Hayward Field is just beyond belief, because growing up being a track athlete, and you always hear about it and you always see it on TV, and it's just like, wow, I'm actually training on that track or in that facility is just life-changing.
I've been on the Air Force triathlon team 3 years prior to getting wounded. And one of my teammates, Major James Bales, is the coach of the Wounded Warrior team for the Air Force. He called me back in November and asked me, hey, have you ever heard of the Warrior Games? And at the time, I didn't. So he knew my background as a football player, and I threw the shot put in high school when I was about 30 pounds heavier. And being a triathlete, we swim, bike, and run all the time. So he said, I've got this thing for you. It's called the Ultimate Champion Competition.
Back in the 90s, I started to bow hunt, and a buddy of mine got me into tournament shooting. And it's a discipline. It's a challenge. You have to be in control of yourself, both emotionally and physically, to shoot well, just like any shooting sport.
So I started playing basketball while I was still in rehab, and every Friday a group of guys in rehab go out and play a different adaptive sport, and for me basketball always just appealed the most. Even though I did not excel at it or play it much pre-injury, I was able to pick it up really quickly and realized how competitive I was, and that motivated me to get better and better to the point of now competing in several national events and having my own custom chair now to propel me and continue on in the future to get better.
Adaptive sports gives me a euphoric feeling, so it's almost as if meditation. And even though I may think about what happened at the event, I still can heal from it at the same time, because I can really put my aggression into it, and then you feel like you actually solved it at that point.
And I think once you come back from an injury, you pick up things way quicker because you're used to it and you have to. And so these clinics and the teammates, what they pick up and how quickly they pick up is phenomenal.
For me personally, adaptive sports has provided an outlet for progress. I've been able to focus on, you know, wheelchair basketball or cycling, and additionally, while getting better at these sports, I'm also improving my body, staying in shape, and advancing my healing process.
I think that the sports that we do at Warrior Games and with adaptive sports programs are very therapeutic. It requires a lot of concentration, so you kind of get your head back in the game. When you're cycling down a mountain in Colorado, you have to focus. When you're looking downrange over your rifle, it's another very mentally challenging sport. And I'm sure the same goes for a lot of the individual sports.
Honestly, I just try to clear my head of everything. You know, I deal with pain all the time, constantly, from wake up, and it just gets worse throughout the day. And I try not to take my pain meds while I shoot, just to help with the focus. So it becomes a challenge, but honestly, I just try to get lost in the X-ring, and everything else kind of takes care of itself.
The physical part is going to come along. As long as you do your therapy, and as long as you are getting up being active, the physical part will come. But the psychological and the social aspect is a little slower process, and it's probably more in depth. So, you know, for me, I probably would have given up a long time ago if it wasn't for the physical aspect. But because of these sports and being able to be around people who are in the same predicament I am, I'm allowed to allow my social being to become full circle, and psychologically I've gotten a lot better.
Adaptive sports, I'd probably be in a lot worse shape physically. Mentally, I wouldn't be focused. I wouldn't have a specific tangible goal, like competing in these different events all over the country. And as far as networking, there's an entire world of disability and the people that I've met over the last 2 years have been absolutely inspirational, and I'll be able to apply those influences to many aspects of my life.
If it weren't for adaptive sports, I would probably be unhappy or depressed. This has opened up a lot of opportunities for me and for a lot of my teammates. We've seen people recover from all kinds of illnesses, psychological or visible, or diseases. It's great to wake up in the morning and think about what you can do.
If it wasn't for adaptive sports, I'd probably still be sitting on a couch eating potato chips. I really don't know what I'd do without it, because that is really, you know, what makes me feel right.
I think without the adaptive sports program, my husband would still be doing archery, but it wouldn't be to the extent that he's doing now. With this program, he's able to go out there and do more than just the local competitions. We have gone to all the competitions in Lejeune and surrounding areas, and maybe a state competition every once in a while. But he's been able to go and participate in the Endeavor Games and the Valor Games, and meet so many other athletes, not only in archery, but different sports. And I think that's really eye-opening, and I really enjoy hearing the stories that he comes back with about the people that have overcome so much because of their adaptive sports programs available to them.
Yeah, without adaptive sports, I would probably be dead. I was one in the beginning, wanted to give up on just about everything. I thought that, you know, I have an opportunity to get back out and do the things that I was normally doing in my life. It was pretty tough on me being an active person to where it just stopped all of abruptly, and I'm laying on my back, and I was one who was about to give up. And the same person that you see now wasn't the same person that you saw 4 years ago, because my mindset wasn't this way. And if it wasn't for adaptive sports, I probably would have given up and just, you know, probably not compete in life again. And some of the things that I've been afforded to gain since I've been injured probably wouldn't occur if I had kept the same mindset that I had at the time of my injury.
Josh. job, Sarah. Good job.
And a lot of times when someone gets wounded, injured, or ill, they create a safe haven, which typically is in their home, and oftentimes they may not want to leave it. But you can't let fear hold you back.
Whatever sport it is, get out of your room, get out of the grind of going to physical therapy and multiple surgeries and just the stress of the hospital. You know, none of us joined the Marine Corps or any of the services to be a patient.
Whether it's individual or it's team sports, I would say just get up and go try it. And if you try something, it's kind of like we tell our kids when they go, you know, to high school. If you get involved in one club, whether it's chess club or the basketball team, if you find out that that's not right for you, go try something else.
Just try it. There is nothing easier than getting off the sofa and going out there and trying something with the Adaptive Sports Program. The kids and I have gone through some of the Adaptive Sports kayaking that they have available, and we found that we truly enjoy that. My husband unfortunately can't go with us because he has an open leg wound, but I'm sure that he would love to get in the pool and do it with us too because he sees how much the kids enjoy it.
You go out and try it. If you fail, so be it. At least you gave it a try. But within that try, it may be something else that you're good at that you can kind of capitalize on and keep striving for.
You know, when you push it hard through a workout, when you push it hard through a race, if you go and tell your mind no when your body can actually perform more and you finish a workout knowing that you did more than you wanted to or that you thought you could do, then you have this incredible sense of accomplishment.
You're gonna get better, you're gonna get bigger, you're gonna get stronger, you're gonna get faster, your technique's gonna build, your endurance is gonna build just from the training that they give you is just top-notch, top-tier, just phenomenal.
No matter what your injury is or what your ailments are, there's a sport for you and there's always an ability to compete at a high level of that sport. So it's all about getting out there and just trying, seeing what you're good at, and odds are you're gonna really enjoy what you do.
Oh my God. Oh, you might have it. You gotta come back up. There you go. Come back up for you. You gotta straighten up some.
Push it.
Got it? It's your arm.
Your arm, not your leg.
Okay, now you gotta pedal out of it. If you can pedal out of it, you win. And our time is up.
I think it's really important for wounded warriors to engage in adaptive sports at any level, whether they want to become competitive or not. There's a camaraderie that goes on, and we all know that there are bad spots, maybe several bad spots, that we face in the road to recovery. And we can help each other. And when we're together focusing on what we can achieve, there's an intense healing process.
When it comes to adaptive sports, the only failure is not trying.
You know, come out here and feel it. Catch the fever, be a part of it, realize the things that you can do. Feel good. Feel good again, completely.
When I recently attended the Warrior Games in Colorado Springs, there were a number of service members who had double leg amputations. And they went to run races, they played in volleyball games, they played in basketball games. There were just no limits to what they could do. So it was very inspiring.
At the Warrior Games, we had a sports psychiatrist who gave us a rubber band. And on that rubber band, we had the opportunity to write down something in our life or a person in our life that inspired you and why. And for me, I wrote Magic Johnson. Because growing up, Magic Johnson was my favorite basketball player. And he became more so a hero to me after my injury because of the situation that he went through in the early 90s when he retired due to having HIV. He did it with a smile, and he never stopped doing what he wanted to do.
Your satisfaction than throwing up after a workout. And it's basically all the coaches that I've had that have inspired me to do so, because otherwise there was no reason to go that far. But I wanted to prove it to them that I would do that for them because they were putting in the time and they were putting in the effort to basically care about me.
My dad was my coach growing up. And so that's what I wanted to do when my son was growing up, is I wanted to be his coach. I wanted to be on the sideline. I wanted to help him develop into a solid athlete like I was, or I thought I was, and now I still am. And so I guess realizing that I was a dad and that I had that to be, that it really kind of focused my life. I pride myself in being a dad, and I love my son, and I show pictures because he is a huge driving force behind my recovery.
Well, I know I'm motivated by my wife and my kids, but as far as like truly inspiring, I went to Endeavor Games a couple weeks back, and the athletes there, you know, not just military disabled vets and stuff like that, but just it's the young kids that don't have arms or don't have legs or have issues with their spine that say, hey, this is my situation and I'm just gonna keep doing it.
When I was injured, I wasn't able to do much for the first time in my life. So I saw people who had been injured like me, they're ahead of me in their progression, and that's what I aspired to be. They were in the varsity, if you want to put it that way. But I just realized that there are guys that have it a lot worse off than me, and I don't see them hanging their heads. I see smiles on their faces, and they're motivated and happy to be there and doing what they're doing, and that inspires me to keep going. So those are fellow wounded warriors are who motivate and inspire me.
A lot of people inspire me, especially in the Navy. It's one of the reasons I joined the Navy. My teammates first and foremost, just watching them on their individual path and what they've been through and the humor that they find and their situations and the things that they look forward to is really inspiring. But it's also knowing that these are people that have confronted their worst fears and their worst case scenarios and that they bounce back from that. And I think that's really one of the most important parts of the military adaptive sports programs.
Everyone is special to me. Whether your name's on a list, whether your name came to me by word of mouth, whether you're a friend of a friend, I want our program to call you. And I want them to possibly have the greatest impact that any program you participated in has had before. To have the greatest impact in your life, in your recovery, and in your family.
My wife is an excellent caretaker. I'm one of the fortunate ones.
Yeah. That's dynamite. We'll keep getting better.
All right, thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. I would offer to you that our recovering service members are their best advocates. They spawn each other to go on and do great things. They are heroes to each other. And I think that, so if you've gotten, you know, those kinds of testimonies, I think that those are the things that we need to share the most. Those are the things that encourage additional service members to engage in adaptive sports.